BDO kicks off its 5 billion peso fixed rate sustainability bond offer. This is the third peso-denominated green bond of the Philippine lender after its 63 and 52 billion peso bond offering early this year and in 2022, respectively. Tenor is a 1.5 years, while the rate per annum is at 6.32%. The offer period is until July 19th, listing on the 24th. Proceeds of this will be used to finance assets in its sustainable finance framework and diversify its funding sources. Security Bank also issuing bonds to support its lending activities. It set the minimum size of its offering to 5 billion pesos to be taken out of its 200 billion peso bond and commercial papers program. The bonds carry a 5-year and 1-month tenor with a fixed rate of 5.7% per annum. Offer period is until August 13, with PDEX listing on the 20th of that month. And finally, new president at First Metro Investment Corporation, home to some of our esteemed market analysts here on the program. FMIC named Anthony Ocampo to the post and also as director to succeed Mr. Jose Patricio Dumlao, who had retired from the company. Ocampo brings with him decades of experience in corporate and investment banking from his time at the Metro Bank Group. He was previously the head of global network banking under Deutsche Bank's corporate and investment bank group. Boeing agrees to plead guilty to a criminal fraud conspiracy charge over two fatal crashes by its 737 MAX planes. The U.S. Justice Department said the embattled plane maker also agreed to pay a fine of over $240 million. By pleading guilty, Boeing will avoid the spectacle of a criminal trial over the two near-identical tragedies that killed 346 passengers and crew. But it is still a significant black mark for the firm, as it means that the company now has a criminal record. Boeing became exposed to criminal prosecution after the DOJ found the company violated a 2021 settlement involving the fatal crashes. Workers at South Korean tech giant Samsung begin a general strike after failing to come to terms with management. The National Samsung Electronics Union, whose roughly 28,000 members make up over a fifth of the firm's workforce, had asked the company for commitments such as improvements to its performance-based bonus system and an extra day of annual leave. The union staged a walkout last month, its first such industrial action. But the company at the time said there was no impact on production or business activity. The union now warning of more damaging action against the country's most powerful conglomerate.